In this episode, we sailed from the British Virgin Islands to Turks and Caicos, a non-stop trip of approximately 440 nautical miles. The reason why we did this passage to Turks and Caicos non-stop is that we were not allowed to visit the US Virgin Islands or Puerto Rico because we didn't have our US visas yet. We applied for them in the Bahamas. This was the only embassy that was open for visa applications when we made our appointment more than 1 year ago during the COVID pandemic. When we had just left the BVI, there were two birds flying along with us. They ended up staying with us for hours and more birds kept coming. It was fascinating to watch them and to see how skilled they are at catching the flying fish that jumped away in front of our boat. We were sailing downwind with the waves at the back, so it was a comfortable ride at an average speed of 6.5 knots, which we were very happy with. The wind blew 20 to 25 knots almost all the way, so we sailed with the jib and full mainsail. With an extra line attached to the jib, we were able to open it more to the side than with the original lagoon setup. This way, we really notice a difference in speed when going downwind.
What you cooking?
Afar.
Delicious.
Soap.
The wind died down a little bit in the evening, but we didn't mind having a calm night. The waves had become slightly bigger and they were pushing us forward, so we were still going at a good speed. We sat on the front deck to enjoy the sunset and to see if there were any dolphins around. We've experienced that on passages we most often see them in the morning and around sunset. There were no dolphins this evening, but it was still nice to enjoy this beautiful and peaceful moment together. The conditions stayed mostly the same as predicted, and we had a quiet night. The second day was pretty much the same as the first one. Not a lot of action, but you don't hear me complaining. The highlight of the day was when we spotted some whales in the distance. We could see them blowing from afar. It was amazing because this was the first time we ever saw whales in the wild. Unfortunately, they were too far away to be seen on camera. We were making good progress. We were already more than halfway by the end of day two and ready for another quiet night.
I bet frenzy. So we made a good progress in the night. Let me show you on the map. Grand Turk is there. It's approximately 110 miles. You want to watch out with these shallows here. We are setting course to Grand Turk.
We had some showers in the morning, but they luckily didn't last long. On day three, we were lucky enough to see some whales close by. Three of them decided to come closer to check out our boat.
That's crazy!
It was only a brief encounter, but it was magical. While enjoying the sunset, we saw a lot more of them blowing further away. Around 7 in the evening, we only had 46 nautical miles to go, so we would arrive at night. It was a little before 4 a.m. when we reached Grand Turk, so we had to anchor in the dark. It's always a bit tricky, especially in areas like these where there are a lot of reefs that you obviously cannot see in the dark. I'm happy we have a forward scan to spot any obstacles in front of us, but I would definitely not advise to do this without accurate charts. We were amazed by the beautiful clear blue water surrounding us in the morning. We couldn't wait to check out these islands that we had never even heard of before we started sailing in the Caribbean. Turks and Caicos Islands are an overseas territory of the United Kingdom in the West Indies. It consists of two groups of islands lying southeast of the Bahamas. Cockburn Town on Grand Turk, where we were, is the seat of the government and main commercial center. What does it say?
It says a lot more about the first post office and the people who owned it and made it. The first post office.
This is the place where Christopher Columbus's first landfall in the Americas may have been. Next week we'll tell you some more about Turks and Caicos, and we'll sail to another magnificent anchorage where the kids have fun on a sandbank and we swim with dolphins. Subscribe and turn on your notifications so you don't miss it. If you like our videos, make sure to hit the like button or even the super thank you button under this video, or you can buy us a virtual drink through the link in the description. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like our video and leave a comment.